The name of this video is Ampere Laplace Biot Savart, or in brief, ALBS equation, the ALBS equation, sometimes also known as just the Biot-Savart equation. But we should give credit to the people, all the people that participated in finding and writing down this very important equation. So this equation is one of the major results of the theory of magnetostatics. And so let's write it down. So we already know that B is a solenoidal field. Therefore, it can be always rewritten as the curl of another field, the vector potential A. And as we have seen in a previous video, we know that if J is a limited distribution in space, then we can always write the vector potential A at an observation point capital P as mu naught over 4 pi, Coulombian type, volume integral in this finite region of space where J is confined, of J vector at the source point capital Q divided by RQP absolute value, well, amplitude, the magnitude dV. All right, so this is what we want to use. Now, we want to plug in this equation here inside the curl of A. Therefore, we obtain that B at any observation point capital P is equal to, well, what we are doing here, we are doing the curl with respect to what? Here we need to be careful. We are doing the curl with respect to P. We are doing the curl with respect to P. This is what we need to do, because the integral is over Q. So A, at the end of the day, is only a function of capital P, and that's what the curl has to be. And so, let's write it down like, as such. The curl, and let us specify that is with respect to P, of all this quantity here, mu naught divided by 4 pi, a volume integral in the region, capital omega, of J at the source point capital Q, divided by RQP dV. Okay, great. So now we can always bring this curl inside the sign of integral because these are all linear expressions. And so we can rewrite eventually this expression here as P at point capital P equal mu naught over 4 pi, which are just constants, a volume integral in our confined region, capital omega space, of the curl with respect to point capital P, of the ratio of two functions, J, which is a vector, Q, divided by scalar RQP, and note that the result of this curl, of course, as such, has to be a vector, and so this one is dV. So now, how do we treat this curl of J over RQP? Well, even though it seems complicated, it's just, again, a derivative operator applied on the ratio of two functions. So we can use the same kind of approach as when we do the derivative of f over g. Let's say f and g are function of time t. Okay, so in this case, what we do is that first we perform the derivative with respect to, say, the denominator, RQP, you will see in a minute why. So if I do it with respect to the denominator, I pick up a minus sign, right? So in this case, this quantity here, I pick up a minus sign, and it's going to be, I take out j, which I'm not deriving, because I'm only deriving the denominator to begin with. This has to become a vector, of course, because it's a curl here, and so I need to cross it with something which gives me a vector, cannot be divergence, cannot be the curl of a scalar, it has to be the gradient of a scalar. So the gradient with respect to p, again, of the quantity ratio of 1 over RQP. Now, let me remind you that RQP vector is equal to RP minus RQ. So P, with respect to a generic origin in space, is what comes first. So if, for some reason, we were performing the curl with respect to Q, something which will happen in 342 for some cases, Well, then we would pick up an extra minus sign because there is this minus sign here. But here there is plus, so with respect to p, no problem. Q is like a constant in this case. Great. So then we will manipulate this in a minute, but let's not forget the other part of the story, which is plus. And now we take out 1 over RQP, which is just a scalar, obviously. And so in order to obtain a vector, this becomes the curl with respect to P of J, but J is only a function of capital Q. Therefore, all this quantity is clearly zero, which means we're only left with this quantity here. This is the beautiful result we get in this case, okay? So we get this minus JQ curl vector, the gradient with respect to P of 1 over RQP. Now, we still need to manipulate this gradient. And so with this definition here, this gradient, so this quantity here, eventually, we are doing the derivative in a vector sense of 1 over r. So of course, we pick another minus sign, because 1 over r is r minus 1. So you get minus 1 over r minus 1 is 2, 1 over r squared, if you want. So minus minus is plus. So we pick a minus from here, and minus from there, so it's plus. So it's plus j, a vector at q, for capital Q. This has to be crossed with 1 over RQP quantity square, but this has to be a vector, and so it goes in the direction of UQP, the unit vector connecting these two points, Q and P. Okay, so this, as always, we can do it with a simple trick, which gives us J of Q. So we just represent this UQP, the unit vector, as RQP, but then we need to normalize it over RQP magnitude to get rid of, to make it unit. And so this becomes divided by RQP quantity cube, okay? Because we are just doing this usual trick of representing UQP as RQP vector divided by RQP. RQP times RQP square, RQP cube. Great. So this is the result we really want to use now. Back in here. And so what we finally obtain from all these manipulations is that B at point capital P, any observation point, A is equal to mu naught over 4 pi. Then we have the volume integral over the region capital omega, which again is limited in space. Otherwise, I cannot use this equation here. Of all this curl, which now, after all these manipulations, nothing but J. And of course, here, we need to have a cross product, otherwise, of course, we don't have a vector, so this is this cross, okay? So we should not forget that. And so we end up having, as a final result up here, J at the source point capital Q, cross it with RQP, divided by RQP cube, integrated over dV. And this is, in fact, the Ampère Laplace Biot-Savart equation, sometimes also called the Laplace's elementary equation, but again, actually all these people really participated. This is this equation. The ALBS equation. We will use it also extensively in 3.42, but a little bit also in this course. All right, but it's very important for something which will become apparent in a minute. So to recapitulate, to recap all this video here, we study the Ampère, Laplace, Biot-Savart, or ALBS equation. We start from the fact that B is solenoidal, so it can be written as the curl of a vector potential A. If J is limited in space, A can be written in Coulombian type, but in a vector sense like this, as we've seen in a previous video. Then we calculate the curl, but we note that the curl has to be with respect to P, the only variable left after this integration. We can bring this, this curl of P inside the sum of the integral, manipulate this integrand, remembering that we are doing just the derivative of the ratio of two functions. So we pick this minus sign here. This goes to zero because J is only a function of Q, not of P, not of P. You can just do as an exercise to solve this in a Cartesian coordinate system and clearly see that, of course, if you have XP and XQ and etc., this curl obviously gives you zero. And then with this in mind, we bring it back in and we find this beautiful final expression for the B field, okay? Given only what nature gives us, which is the current density. That's it.